But right now, a panel of four distinguished senators have joined us in Washington. They are Senator John Warner, Republican of Virginia, ranking member of the Armed Services Committee. Senator John Kerry, Democrat of Massachusetts, a member of the Foreign Relations Committee, including the Subcommittee on International Operations and Terrorism. Senator Dianne Feinstein, Democrat of California, member of the Select Intelligence Committee. She's chairing the Judiciary Committee Subcommittee on Technology, Terrorism, and Government Information. And Senator Fred Thompson, Republican of Tennessee, a member of the Select Intelligence Committee, a ranking member of Governmental Affairs. We'll start with Senator Warner. Was this a failure of information techniques tonight and today, Senator?
Well, Larry, I spent much of the afternoon with the Secretary of Defense and the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and indeed had an opportunity to talk with the President from the Pentagon. That we assess tomorrow. Tonight, we grieve for those who've lost their lives, the wounded, their families, and we look upon this as the greatest tragedy in the history of our country, but also one of its finest hours, when we've seen this country come together like never before, whether it's the firemen or the rescue operators or the military all over the world, and we stand with one voice being spoken by our president, and he did very well tonight.
Senator Kerry, did your Committee on International Operations and Terrorism ever actually fear something like this?
Absolutely. But let me join John, and I know all my colleagues, in just expressing, I mean, I think all of us here in Washington are feeling, in very personal ways, the loss of what's happened here. I know that I had one friend I know of already on that plane from Boston, and I dread the learning of perhaps others, but for thousands of families tonight, there is just a huge loss. And I think in every American, there's a sense of there's a fury, an intense burning fury about this, and a determination to do what is right about it. We have always known this could happen. We've warned about it. We've talked about it. I regret to say, as a I served on the Intelligence Committee up until last year. I can remember after the bombings of the embassies, after TWA 800, we went through this flurry of activity talking about it, but not really doing the hard work of responding. We need to do that now, and I'm confident that the size of this, the nature of this loss, and the nature of this attack are going to motivate everybody to come together to do that. And I think that's imperative. And we also, I think, Larry, I was heartened by the President's comments tonight, need to make certain that those countries that sponsor terrorism, that support it, that harbor these fugitives, are as much a part of the problem as those who engage in the terrorist act themselves. And we need to make certain as a country we respond to that boldly and bravely, and not recklessly, but boldly.
Senator Feinstein, what are the next few days going to be like? There's going to be opinions from, what's your read on what's next?
Oh, I think there are many of us that feel that this was an act of war against the United States, that its loss is going, our human loss is going to be extreme, that the deviltry, the cunning, and the evil behind the act is extraordinary, and that we need to respond, and that America needs to come together with a unity and a purpose and respond. We cannot be a tape paper tiger. This act, in my view, it wasn't coincidence now that the World Trade Center has been the victim twice. And I think it's a symbol of America, and it's a symbol of what we want to protect as well. And so I think tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock, the leadership has announced that there will be a resolution on the floor of the Senate for many of us. And I'm one that believes very strongly that rather than arguing over missile defense, the asymmetric threat against the United States is the most serious one. And we've had a good indication of that today.
Senator Thompson, President John F. Kennedy once said, when asked about his own safety, if someone is willing to give up their own life, that is almost impossible to protect against. What do you do when you have people like today, obviously in numbers more than 10 of the total four planes, who died for this? How do you counter that?
Very difficult. I think there'll always be a window of vulnerability that we'll have. We're living in a different world now. I think we let our defenses down a bit after the Cold War and wanted to enjoy the peace dividend. But the fact of the matter is the world's a more dangerous place in many respects than it has been in times past. We're now seeing the other side of the technology coin. Technology has been a wonderful thing for us. But it also allows bad people to do bad things that they couldn't do a short time ago. We saw one form of that today, probably in the communications area. There are several other threats out there, though. The missile threat is one of them. It is real. The cyber terrorism that could shut down our computers and our communication networks and our transportation system and all that is very real. We simply have to get about implementing the policies, appropriating the funds necessary to address these across the board.
Senator Warner, what do you say to Americans in their grief about what they should do? You try not to let terrorism affect you, but people are not going to go easily to airports tomorrow. What do you say to them?
Have faith in this greater country. We've survived, although this is the worst, we've survived other crises. I see tonight in Washington, among my colleagues, we're no longer Democrat, Republican. We're united as a Congress behind our president, and we're going to take every step. Number one, to find out what happened and see that it cannot be repeated. And secondly, we're a nation under the rule of law, but we will relentlessly pursue and hold accountable those who perpetrated this crime against our citizens.
And when we pursue that, Senator Kerry, does America as a nation pursue it legally? Does it go through world courts, or does it take off?
There are three ways to pursue it, Larry. One is multilaterally, which takes more time. That's the way George Bush, the father, did it in the Gulf War. You can do it bilaterally, you and another nation. You can reach an agreement. You can work together. And you can do it unilaterally when the circumstances call for it. I personally believe this is a circumstance because of the nature of it. As Diane said, as many have said today, this is an act of war. The difficulty is, unlike Pearl Harbor, this is a stealth enemy. Japan was identifiable. We knew where to find them ultimately, you know, and after chasing around, and we could identify. Here, we know pretty much. I mean, there's a great certainty among many people about where the fingers point. But ultimately, we don't want to be a terrorist ourselves. We have to do what we do with the knowledge and the certainty that we can determine, but we must be prepared, absolutely, to move unilaterally if we need to protect the honor and the civility that we stand for. And I think that everybody in this country would support that based on the proper response with the proper information.
Senator Feinstein, what if? What if it's bin Laden? Well, if it is bin Laden, if?
Well,
what do you do? You go into Afghanistan, you look for him, you bomb? What do you do?
I don't think America can be a paper tiger in this instance. This was a major attack, and let's face it, there isn't going to be chaos. We're not going to bend down. We are going to rise up as one people. And it's got to be stopped, and you have to ferret it out. I agree with what Dick Holbrooke said on this network earlier. You've got to work with our allies, the NATO allies, particularly Russia, China, and the moderate Arab countries. That's Egypt, that's Jordan, that's the Saudis. And we have to make a statement that is so strong that any country that harbors, that trains, that gives money to, that supports, becomes an enemy of the civilized world. Because if this can happen here, it can happen in other places. Terrorism, as our report will say very shortly, isn't a crisis, it's an ongoing condition. And we've got to change the condition. So I must say, I feel very strongly about this, that the United States must respond. Those of us that have had the classified briefings over a period of time understand some of the networks that are functioning out there, even in this country, as a matter of fact. And it's not too difficult to put together two and two, and I think get four.
All right. Senator Thompson?
Can I just say that Putin was one of the first heads of state to call our president And the Secretary of Defense this afternoon, colleagues, I was there when he talked with the Russian defense minister. That's an example of the type of support we're getting. The world has got to come and help us solve this problem, because terrorism is a common enemy to all of us.
And Senator Thompson, if the state that harbors them is as responsible as those who commit it, therefore, are those civilians in peril?
Yes, they are. The powers that be in those nations have put them in peril. Saddam uses his civilians, as we know. There's no way around that, but we've got to face up to it. I agree with Diane that the greatest deterrent that we can have is the knowledge in the minds of potential terrorists around the world that there will be swift, accurate retribution. Unfortunately, there's just no way around that.
And Larry, could I just
thank you. We're out of time, but we'll do a lot more with you in the nights ahead with all four of you and others.